Welcome to whiskey.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning, this is my son Ben, and today we have a closer look to the Redbreast, 12 years of age. And I had that whiskey a few years ago, several times, and I remember it to be an intense one. And it's called the Redbreast, and well, this is this small little bird with the red breast. Mm-hmm. And Robin Redbreast, that's not the American Redbreast. It's the European relative, and here in southern Bavaria, where we live, the redbreast does not stay over winter, but in Ireland, mm-hmm. it stays over winter, and it sings all day long, even in the night. So this is, yeah, stand fast, we're Irish, we're here to stay. And this is the name patron of the whiskey. Yeah, it's very, very Irish in this way, and this is a... Well, a pot still whiskey, and now we have to discuss a few differences to the Scottish cousins. Pot still whiskey does not have to be a malt whiskey in Ireland. So pot still whiskey can be a, well, an unfermented, an unmalted barley or other grain. In this case, it's barley, and is mixed with a malted barley. And both together go into the pot still, and then it's called single pot still. In former times it was called pure pot still, but today it's called single pot still. Well, to have the name single in the name of the whiskey, as the Scottish cousins have for mm-hmm. single malt. So it's single pot still. That does not mean that everything is single malt, but everything is barley.
Mm-hmm. And what is really nice is that the Irish have the tradition of triple distilling.
Yes. Yeah.
And I think it's matured in bourbon and in Oloroso sherry cask, so I'm really, really getting a feel for it, and I think this could be a really good one. I've never tried it yet.
Yeah, there are a few other redbreasts out there as well. They have older ages, there is cask strength under its way, but they are quite rare. The 12-year-old is the masterpiece. The majority of whiskies is bottled at 12 years, and this whiskey comes from... Street is the whiskey is from the Middleton distillery in the very south of Ireland, and yeah, this is a name, it does not carry the name of the distillery. This is quite popular in Ireland to have
so names. Few distilleries left that they want to branch out with their brands.
Yes, but I think the tenfold. They tenfolded the number of distilleries over the last 10 years.
I just had it last week or the week before for you in the news. They just opened up a new distillery and they're now up to 23.
Okay.
And in the year 2013, so 6 years ago, they had been at 4.
Yeah.
So the Irish whiskey is getting a revival.
Mm-hmm. So there is sherry in it.
Yeah, it's fruity, it's somewhat sweet, but a lot of sherry tones, a bit of grapes, wine, juice.
Yeah, the grape. There's a light, cool note.
Yep.
I thought first it was alcohol, but it's a winey note. And with the second dram, now there is vanilla and caramel as well. That wasn't there in the first sip. So the spiciness appears already. Yeah.
It has a little bit of spiciness.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a deep sherry note. That the wine is not a light wine, but one of these heavy wines.
So that's becoming stronger and stronger the longer you have it in your mouth. And typically on column stills, which are very typical for Ireland, from each plate to each plate, the alcohol gets purer and purer and purer. In the end, you have a very smooth alcohol. This is a single or pure pot still, only produced on pot stills. And with this, there's more peppery, more spicy note in the malt or in the raw whiskey. But they're distilling three times. So that there is a little bit less of that. But then the cask kicks in. And it's really, really spicy, going over to a big, big oakiness, which develops into, well, coffee espresso notes. Quite a hint of bitterness in it.
At the first, at the very first glance in your mouth, you do have a smooth bit of sweetness, just a gentle touch. And then really, as you said, the spiciness kicks in, the oak takes over, and you get a bit of a bitterness with cacao, coffee, dark chocolate, and that oak really comes through.
Mm. Yeah, the second sip even intensifies that, so that the spiciness is stronger now in my mouth. And I read that here on the tasting notes. Nose, a complex, spicy and fruity aroma with toasted wood notes evident. So this spicy in the nose, not really. It's starting to give some spicy notes, but most of it, from my point of view, is fruity. Taste, full-flavored and complex, yeah. A harmonious balance of spicy, creamy, fruity sherry and toasted notes. So this letters, the fonts used is light, bold, italic. It's missing bold italic, and they are mixing everything through in here. It's awful. It's incredible, stupid what they're writing down there. Yeah. So they
prove to highlight everything.
So they prove they have no marketing taste or design taste. Yes, Sherry.
But their taste profile is pretty good.
Is pretty much like, the right thing, yeah. Mm-hmm. Finish satisfyingly long, the complex flavors linger on the palate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I like it, but it's a heavy one. It's definitely a heavy one. It's a strong, heavy flavored Irish whiskey. I think they must be distilling pretty fast to get all the, to keep all the hefty, deep, oily flavor types in there.
Yeah, and most of the Irish whiskies carry no age statement. So they're young, they're 3 years and a day. And this is full 12 years. And I visited the old Middleton Distillery and the new Middleton Distillery. And there they build a new warehouse every year. It has the size of half a soccer field or a rugby field. And they're filled to the top, 6-8 casks high. They're standing upside, not rolling, palletized upside. And every year they build a new warehouse. So now they are at 34, 2013 I've been there, 34 warehouses. Now they have to be close to 40. Mm. So it's incredible what's maturing there. And the Redbreast is, well, the excerpt out of those casks because they take the old ones from there. Yeah, really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like it. You should really like the heavy taste to get the feel for the red breast. Yeah. It's a bit strange that you have that little gentle bird there and then such a hefty whiskey.
Stand fast.
Stand fast for this one. Okay, thank you very much for watching. If you found this video interesting, then please feel free to share it with your friends and see you next time.